Hello everybody. Today we are going to talk about eclipses. We'll talk about how and why eclipses occur, and we will talk in detail about types of solar and lunar eclipses. Let us start with the word eclipse. So what is an eclipse? Eclipse is a phenomena in which an object is obscured from view, either because some other objects come in between the observer and the object you are viewing, or because the object is shadowed by some other object. Let us now start with the first type of eclipse that we are going to talk about. Solar eclipses. Solar eclipses are the eclipses of sun. What happens in a solar eclipse? In a solar eclipse, as we know, the moon comes in between the sun and the earth, and the shadow of the moon falls on the earth. This shadow can be divided into two parts. One is the darker umbra, which is in this cone, and the other is the fainter, which is the penumbra, which is seen because of the cross rays here. While looking at eclipse from the earth, what do you actually see? So you see the sun, and suddenly the sun becomes obscured by moon and the sky becomes dark, so dark that you can actually start seeing stars. And then again the sun starts to glow with its full glory. This is the beautiful phenomena of solar eclipse, in which you experience night during the daytime for a few minutes. This was an Earth-based observer's view of the solar eclipse. What if I am in a space station? How will I see the eclipse? So we just talked that the shadow of the moon falls on the Earth. So on my right, you will see that the Earth, as the day begins, you can see a shadow of moon passing through the lower region of Earth. People staying in this part of Earth, as the shadow of moon moves, they will see a solar eclipse. On the other hand, if you see to the right, here is an animation in which you will see that as the eclipse progresses, the dark spot, which is the umbra, is the place, or is from where the umbra moves, is the region where people will see the full total eclipse. On the other hand, the other region, the fainter region that you see, which is much larger, is the region of penumbra. How do people in umbra and penumbra see the eclipse? So if I am standing in the umbra, or where the dark shadow of moon falls on the earth, what I am going to see is a total solar eclipse. The moon will completely cover the sun. On the other hand, if I am staying somewhere in the region where the penumbra falls, what I am going to see is a partial solar eclipse, where the moon cannot or will not completely cover the sun's disk. This tells us that there are different types of eclipse. What are the different types of eclipse? There is a total solar eclipse, where the moon completely covers the sun. There is a partial solar eclipse, where the moon partially covers the sun. But there is also another type of eclipse, which is called as an annular solar eclipse, where the moon cannot completely cover the sun, and you see something called as an annulus, or a ring of sun. Why does this happen? For this, we have to go a bit deeper into the sizes of these objects and their distances. But before that, what happens as the eclipse progresses is shown in this beautiful collage of images of solar eclipse. So you can see from the left to the right, the sun is being slowly engulfed by the moon's disk. And as the eclipse progresses, more and more part of the sun is being covered by the moon. At one point, when the sun is almost completely covered by the moon, you will see something like this. This is called as the diamond ring effect. And why does this occur? Because the moon is not a perfect sphere. There are many mountains, many valleys on the moon. And this is the time when you see this diamond ring effect. After the diamond ring, you see the totality, the total solar eclipse, where the moon is now completely covering the sun, and a magnificent thing happens at this time, that is, the sky is completely dark and you start seeing something called as the solar corona. This is the outermost layer of sun which is not visible to us otherwise. People use artificial eclipses to study this outer layer of sun called as corona, and we'll talk about this later sometime. Also, there is a very interesting phenomena that happens sometime near when the diamond ring is occurring. You will see some bright spots when the moon is almost going to cover the sun. These were initially unexplained, but in 1870s, a person named Bayles, he first said that these are because of the uneven surface of the moon. There are mountains, there are valleys, and you see these are hence called as Bayles beads. Then slowly, the moon starts moving away from the solar disk and you see more and more of the sun's disk and the eclipse ends. This may not happen exactly in one line, and we'll talk about that some other time. Question is, we have seen in the scales of solar system video that the sun is almost 400 times bigger than the moon. Then how can the moon cover the sun? The answer is simple. Since the sun is very far away from us, very far away from Earth, and the moon is pretty close to us, you can see the distances here, the size to the distance ratio of sun and moon comes out to be same. In other words, the angular size that human beings see of the sun and moon in the sky are almost same. This is very unique to Earth. We are very lucky to be here on Earth and witness this phenomena. So that is the reason why the sun is completely covered by the moon's disk. Then how can the annular solar eclipse occur if the sun is completely covered by the moon? The reason is simple. Let us have a look at the ray diagram. So again, here is sun, here is moon, and here is Earth. Now the distances are such that sometimes, because we know the orbit of Earth around sun and orbit of moon around Earth are elliptical, sometimes it may happen that the distance is such that the moon is slightly further away and the umbra doesn't fall exactly on the Earth. So what happens is you get this kind of pattern, and this region of the shadow is called as antumbra. If you are standing in the antumbra, what you are going to see is the annular solar eclipse. Again, coming to the distances and the sizes, let us say if the Earth is closest to the sun, that is, the Earth is at perihelion, which indirectly means that you will see a larger solar disk because the Earth is closer to the sun. If during that time the moon is farthest away from Earth, that means the angular size of moon is lesser as compared to its usual size. In such a case, what is going to happen is this distance to size ratio changes, and the lunar disk then subtends a smaller angle in the sky, and the solar disk subtends a larger angle, and we see an annular eclipse. So for an annular eclipse to occur, the Earth has to be at perihelion, that is nearest to sun, and the moon has to be at apogee, that is farthest away from Earth. So this is the antumbra, and this is the view that you get from antumbra, the annulus or the ring of sun or ring of fire that you see in the sky. Interestingly, there is another type of eclipse which is called as an hybrid solar eclipse. What is an hybrid solar eclipse? So as you can see, it is an eclipse where some part of Earth will see a total solar eclipse and some part of Earth will see an annular solar eclipse. And as you can understand, or as you might have guessed already, this is because of the curvature of Earth. Remember, the Earth is a huge sphere. It is a huge ball on which we stay. And you can see here that sometimes, in very special cases, the moon's umbra almost touches the Earth's surface, and people here will see a total solar eclipse. On the other hand, if as the moon progresses in its path and the shadow moves along the Earth's surface, at some point the umbra is no longer touching the Earth's surface, and what you see here is the antumbra and an annular solar eclipse. So this is an interesting eclipse called as the hybrid solar eclipse. Now, how to see an eclipse? Eclipse, solar eclipse is one of the most magnificent phenomena that you will ever witness. But there are certain precautions that one needs to take. You cannot directly look at the sun because that is going to trouble your eyes. So what you do to view eclipses? You have specialized goggle, as you can see here, some of my friends and colleagues are wearing those goggles. These goggles are specially made to view solar eclipses. On the other hand, if you have telescopes, you have filters for telescopes called as solar filters, and you have to use only those to look at eclipses and never look at sun directly or never look at an eclipse directly. This brings us to the end of solar eclipse. Now let us talk about the lunar eclipses. Lunar eclipses are basically the eclipse of moon, and lunar eclipse occurs on a full moon day. When does a lunar eclipse occur? So the Earth comes in between the sun and the moon, and the shadow of the Earth, which is falling in this direction, the moon happens to pass through that shadow. And because the moon is passing through that shadow, we see a lunar eclipse. Here you can see a nice video of lunar eclipse. You can see how the moon is slowly being covered by the shadow of the Earth, or as the moon is moving into the shadow of the Earth, you can see it is being obscured, and suddenly the moon becomes red. This is the total lunar eclipse that we are talking about. The moon is red. The moon doesn't disappear. And we will see why this happens. Again, just like solar eclipse, there are types of lunar eclipses. One is total lunar eclipse, that is, the moon is completely red here, you can see. The other is partial lunar eclipse. If you remember, we have seen one such photo when we talked about phases of moon, but we have said that how the phase and the eclipses are different. Here is the partial lunar eclipse. You can see the curvature is this way of the shadow of Earth. And then you have penumbral eclipse. That means the moon is passing through the penumbral shadow of Earth. So these total lunar eclipses, or these types of lunar eclipses, how do they occur? Here, you can see that as the moon moves through the penumbra of Earth, you see a penumbral eclipse. During the penumbral eclipse, the intensity of moon slightly drops, and sometimes it is not even very significant, and you may miss it. During a total lunar eclipse, the moon first enters the penumbral shadow of Earth, goes to the umbra, where it becomes completely red, then it moves out, again goes to the penumbra and moves out. This is called as a total lunar eclipse, where the moon appears red. And then there is a partial lunar eclipse, where the moon partially crosses through the umbra, and you see a partial lunar eclipse. This is a beautiful collage of the photos of lunar eclipse. You can see different phases of lunar eclipse, and then at the center, you can see the total lunar eclipse. This happened on 28th January 2019. But why does the moon appear red? Why doesn't the moon appear completely dark? The reason is this. When the light, the white light or the sunlight, which is composed of various colors, when it passes through the atmosphere of Earth, what happens is the blue light gets scattered the most, and the red light gets scattered the least. This scattering is a wavelength dependent phenomena, and because of this, you see that the red light passes through the atmosphere unscattered and reaches the moon, and hence the moon appears red. This scattering is called as Rayleigh scattering, and we will have a separate video talking more about Rayleigh scattering later. This is the reason the moon doesn't appear completely dark, but it appears red in a total lunar eclipse. Here is a video from NASA where we will be seeing about lunar eclipses. You see the moon here, and you can see as the moon moves in the shadow of Earth, first the penumbra, then the umbra, you will see an eclipse, which you can see here, the moon becomes red, and then in the penumbra, and then out of eclipse. So as the Earth is going around Sun, and the moon is going around Earth, it enters the penumbral region, then it enters the umbral region. In the penumbra, the intensity slightly decreases, the brightness slightly decreases. Then it enters the umbra, then it becomes red because of the scattering, and then you see the total eclipse. Here you will see how the scattering happens and why the moon appears red during the eclipse. The red light is scattered least, the blue light is scattered most because of the atmosphere, and the moon appears red in the sky during the total lunar eclipse. And this is a very beautiful sight to see. You don't need any special equipments to see a lunar eclipse. Here is another collage of the lunar eclipse and a beautiful image of lunar eclipse. Towards the end of the video, we will just recap how solar eclipse and lunar eclipse is different. In solar eclipse, the moon is in the new moon phase. The moon is between the Sun and Earth. And the shadow of moon falls on the Earth, a small region of Earth, and people in that shadow will either see an partial or annular or a total solar eclipse depending on where they are. On the other hand, in the lunar eclipse, what happens is the moon is now in a full moon phase, and the Earth's shadow, which is cast because of the Sun, the moon happens to pass through the shadow. From which region of the shadow the moon passes, we see different types of lunar eclipse, like penumbral, partial, or total lunar eclipse. Remember, most of the images that we have seen here are not to the scale. Making to the scale images and showing them on the screen is slightly difficult. So this point is to be remembered by us, that these images are not to the scale. Now, an obvious question to think about is, why don't a lunar eclipse occur on every full moon day, or a solar eclipse occur on every new moon day? The reason is simple. Here you can see the plane of Sun and Earth, which is called as ecliptic, and the plane of Moon around Earth. These two planes are tilted with respect to each other at an angle of around 5 degrees. So the moon is sometimes above the ecliptic, sometimes it is below the ecliptic. Unless it is at a node, or all these three celestial bodies, the Sun, the Moon, and Earth, are aligned, you don't see an eclipse. This is the reason we don't see eclipses on every new moon or every full moon day. In the later videos, we will talk more in detail about eclipses. For instance, what is a Saros cycle? What are the statistics of eclipse? Like, how many eclipses can occur in a year? How many of them will be solar? How many of them will be lunar? We will also try to calculate how far the Sun or the Moon should be from the node so that an eclipse should occur. All these things in the upcoming videos. Thank you.